Hello, everyone. Let me start by thanking the New York Green Bank for inviting me to be part of the International Green Bank Summit. I regret I cannot join you in New York, which is emerging as an epicenter of action in this crucial time period for global response to climate change. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a time period to watch carefully, because the last few months and the coming months will significantly alter the global banking and investment landscape. This change has already begun. The wheels are in motion. Consider the events of September right there in New York. The People's Climate March, with hundreds of thousands of people marching in the streets, showed unprecedented popular support for climate action such as divestment, regulations, and green goods. Corporate leaders at Climate Week shared their climate risks and their path to prosperity in a low-carbon economy. Lowering costs with renewables and resilient supply chains, and raising margins with efficient transportation facilities and operations. And heads of state and government, joined by leaders of industry and civil society, made pledges at the Secretary General's Climate Summit and ratcheted up their will to act across public and private sectors. Some of the summit outcomes are explicitly financial and are already changing the global investment landscape. Institutional investors committed to quickly decarbonize $100 billion in assets and disclose the footprint of $500 billion more. The insurance industry will double green investments in 2015 and ramp it up tenfold by 2020. More than 1,000 companies and 75 governments stood in support of a price on carbon. We have seen a historic mobilization of industry, investors, governments at all levels, and millions of people. This mobilization is part of a larger trend towards low carbon and climate safe, emerging in public policy and investment strategy. The green bond market is taking off. The cost of renewables is rapidly falling. Energy efficiency provides immediate returns. Funds and financial institutions are examining potentially stranded assets, firms, climate footprints, and supply chain resilience. Clearly, the market is responding as the world wakes up to the risk of inaction and the great opportunity that clean energy opens at a moment when we know a massive mobilization of capital is needed to upgrade energy infrastructure in coming years. While the direction of the energy mix is the right one, the speed is not. We have the opportunity to unleash the full potential of human determination and ingenuity, in particular in financial and technological sectors. We must seize this opportunity, and we must do so now. This makes the next few months extremely important for the planet, for the people who live here, and for future generations. The coming months must provide further clarity on the future direction of global, social, and economic development. We will have a draft new Universal Climate Change Agreement in Lima this year, a new framework for growth. Following the important announcements recently made, early next year, the rest of the countries will share their contributions to this new agreement. And in December of 2015, the new Universal Climate Change Agreement will be adopted in Paris. Ambition now can usher in a new era of stability, growth, and prosperity. Climate change is a complex and evolving issue. It is a new set of risks. Banks and investors who respond proactively open opportunity and prosper in the transition to low carbon growth. You have an important role to play in accelerating that transition. I ask you today to intentionally help speed up and scale up this transition. Fund greener development with focus on developing countries. De-risk low carbon investment to increase private investment. And speak out for further bold commitments to the Green Climate Fund to boost donor confidence in this crucial moment for that new institution. And I ask you to vocally advocate for a new universal climate change agreement that points global growth in a climate-neutral direction that is good for a greener marketplace, people and communities, and the planet. Together, we can make green growth the new normal and guarantee better returns for generations to come. Thank you, and I look forward to seeing the outcomes of your summit.